Halo sahabat Koi, ketemu lagi bersama saya Arina Chasni di Koispedia, yang awam jadi paham.
Di sini yang awam jadi paham, semua bisa main Koi. Di sini Koispedia, semua bisa main Koi.
Nah, hari ini pas banget kita kedatangan tamu spesial dari lintas benua. Wow, luar biasa ya. Cuman di Koispedia bisa datangin narasumber-narasumber gak cuman lokalan, tapi kita kelasnya udah international. So, this episode will be held in English, mixed with Chinese and a little bit of Indonesia or Sundanese ya.
Enggak
ya. Enggak Sundanese ya. But anyway, let me introduce our narasumber for today, and I will be the moderator for this episode. So on the other side of the table, please welcome Mr. Henry. Woo! Okay, he's my brother in another mother.
Oh,
yeah. So
real brother.
No.
Yeah, real brother is different.
Okay. And from the my brother from another country is Mr. Aaron Goh.
Hello, from Malaysia.
Oh, hello, kawan Malaysia. Okay, and on the other side is Mr. Chu from China. Wow.
大家好，印度尼西亚的你好。你好。
So you should, kalian harus kalau misalkan ada bilang ni hao, you should answer ni hao ma.
Yeah.
Yes, yeah, correct.
Good.
Man, I'm good in Mandarin. A little bit. Okay, so this episode should be more fun because we are going to questioning your arrival or your stay in Indonesia. But before that, I want to ask you about what's the meaning of your Koi's company names. It's Shushin.
Shushin.
Yes, it's a little bit catchy name.
Yeah.
But we all have to know what it's the meaning.
The meaning of Shushin.
Yes.
刚做一个开始，他们就想问，就是说这个书信 的名称的意思.
Oh, sorry, but first of all, thank you for coming to Indonesia. Thank you for coming to Koispedia. I'm
yeah,
a little bit more.
Always welcome. Don't worry.
Yes, I'm a little bit excited, so right. I forgot to congratulate you. Okay, please continue.
就是书信的名是什么意思？就是从哪里来？哦，
书信呢，它是源于汉字。 苏呢就是代表我们所在地，就是苏州。信呢就是中国做生意诚信的取的一个字，叫苏信。
The name of Shushin come from a Chinese words. Okay, for the Shu, it means a name of Shuzhou. Okay, they take the first word, and for Xing, that means it's a belief, and it's the words of integrity. The meaning is the integrity.
Okay. Oh, so cool. It's the meaning of integrity. Yeah? It's a very deep meaning,
yep.
And then very promising, yeah?
Yeah, it's very promising.
Yes. Okay, so, any question, Mr. No. Henry? Oh, no.
Not yet.
Okay.
Let's warm up first.
Oh,
warm up first. Okay.
Okay. He's waiting the right moment to tackle
us.
You.
Yeah.
Okay, Chinese is a country that very famous for historical.
Yeah.
Yes, everything there is.
中国是一个很有历史性的国家.
Yes. Always connected to your ancients.
Yeah.
Yes, it's like we all knew about Feng Shui, yeah, Xiu. Something like that. Is it Shushin names related to one of those?
Related to
your ancients, maybe, or a goddess, or god, or
Shushin 有没有联系到就是一个古代的故事啊，或者是一个神奇的东西？
苏信没有，因为苏信是一个现代的科技型的公司。 我们的口号叫科技缔造极致美。
There's no relationship about ancient because Suxing is a very modern and a scientific company. It's a very modern company right now.
Okay.
So everything what they do is according to the scientific way. It's a big company doing things in a very modern way.
So Suxing don't believe the
ancient things and all that. No.
但是呢，我们的 logo 是采用了苏州最传统的花窗的纹样，所以也秉承了中国的传统文化。
Except one thing is their logo represent the 苏州的文化。
苏州的窗口。
It just look like a ancient window of a 苏州 building. This logo look like an ancient window.If you're talking about ancient things, only the logo.
At the pagodas.
It's a window. It's a window of the ancient building.
Yeah. Ah, okay.
So normally last time, if you look at those like old movie,
the window
is something rounded, and then you have beautiful girl behind.
So
beautiful girl always stand behind.
Okay.
With the fan, yeah.
Yeah.
所以我们是一个秉承传统、不断创新的一个企业。
It's a ancient. If you're got saying that it's a ancient company, that means it's not related to ancient, but they always try to do something new.
Okay.
They try to create something new out of the traditional way.
Okay.
所以在我们做鱼的时候呢，做锦鲤的时候，也是秉承了传统，然后不断的创新，加以科技，所以才会取得现在更大型化、更好的鱼。
Just like the way they are producing koi, it means that they follow the traditional way, but they create a new thing out of the traditional way. Yeah.
Ah, okay. Oh, okay. So interest, very interesting. Yeah. So you choose the red colors means lucky colors in Chinese. Am I right?
就是你选用了这个红色是代表幸运的颜色。
中国的国旗的颜色就是红色。
The China flag actually is in red color.
中国
represent China.
比较喜庆的颜色也是红色。
And then normally Chinese always like red color. For example, they give ang pao also is a red color. And when you receive ang pao, you will be very happy.Yeah.
Jadi kalau dilihat itu tadi benar-benar sesuatu yang meaningful banget, deep banget ya artinya. Jadi your vision and mission is clear.
Yep. Ya.
Tapi mereka ini adalah orang-orang modern yang nggak kolot mungkin ya kalau dalam bahasa Indonesia tuh. Jadi penuh dengan visi misi yang lebih inovatif buat perusahaannya si Suxing itu. Here in Indonesia.There's phenomena. Made in China is everywhere. So everything is made in China, from head to toe. Like, you name it. China has made it all of it. And now, in koi breeding industry. So please tell us.
Let me explain to him first.
Okay. Please.
所以他们印尼人的印象中，就是整个印尼的生活其实都覆盖。被中国覆盖，就是服装啊，从头到尾啊，全都是中国制造的东西，所以他们对中国已经有一个平板的印象了。现在他是要讲的是在锦鲤中 ，Okay for the koi.
For the koi.
Yeah.
So how about you started this business?
Okay.
How?
你在中，就是说你怎么会开始这个锦鲤的？生意或者是这个锦鲤的繁殖。
首先呢，就是锦鲤源于中国唐朝。
First of all, the chai, this koi actually started from China during Tang Dynasty.
Yeah. Oh, Tang Dynasty.
Yeah. Yeah.
So actually koi actually originally the ancient is from China. 它是由中国传到日本的，然后呢，锦鲤呢在日本发扬光大。 And then it was sent to China, and then sent from China to Japan, and then at Japan they come up with those color and crossbreed, then become famous in Japan.
Yeah.
How come?
Yeah.
Can I complain?
Yeah. Can, no problem. We can complain.
Oh, no, you on the contradictive side.
No. I'm just in curiosity.
Okay.
Curiosity. Just as I know and as I read from the many literature online or books, from China and Tang Dynasty is the ordinary crop.
Yeah, it's the ordinary cup, like chaboy.
That right.
Yeah, only a single color.
Single color, right?
Yep.
So like in Indonesia we call this ikan mas.
Ah, goldfish.
Ikan mas. Okay.
Ikan mas yang kita makan.
Bukan goldfish ya itu ya?
Bukan, ikan mas. Ikan mas itu ikan mas.
Yeah.
So the ordinary crab. That what I know, right? And become koi in Japan. So in Japan. The color become a fancy, get the red one, white one,
red and white.
And until now, there's many mutation and many changes, right?
Yep.
So for me, that's mean koi, ordinary cup from China, but koi from Japan. Is it right?
他的印象中就是他的问题就是说，你是说。 原本是从中国过去的嘛，原本过去从中国过去的时候，只是一个草履，就是菜，只是一个菜履，
对，
没有颜色的，是食用的，
对，然后就是去到日本才被发扬光大嘛，才会变得很多红白啊，其他颜色杂交出来，
是的，所以说锦鲤是应该是日本的，草履才是中国的，
应该是这样。 就是从历史追溯当中，在中国现在的文献当中，就是我个人掌握的一些里面呢，就是在锦鲤这样一个词，就要提到苏姓的苏这个字，在中国最早记载锦鲤这个名词的时候是唐朝的诗人陆龟蒙，他有一个诗词叫《锦鲤绕岛引》。So
actually, in China during Tang Dynasty, also already have koi. Jingli is koi. Okay. It's not ordinary koi. It means it's colorful koi. During that time, they also already have record in the history of certain books that mention about koi during Tang Dynasty.
第二件事情呢，还有我现在下次可以提供你一张在汉朝的时候出土的一件文物，它是在汉朝的一个墓里面一个碑，上面就有。 中国的达官贵人去喂鱼赏鱼的一个场景。
Okay, they have even this records on certain books during Han's dynasty. Han, they already have people feeding koi, colorful koi at China.
所以呢，就是把鱼饲养了以后去观赏这个作用，就这样有观赏作用的时候，是在中国的唐朝和汉朝就已经有了。当然，它花纹另外一说啊。During
Tang and Han dynasty, already have koi, not for food, but for keeping.
It means that 它最早传到日本的时候，仅仅是为了食用。
The cup that they send to Japan is for food consumption. So actually, during that time, they already have color koi in China. They can have a proof, a record, and everything, and show it to you next time. Okay. Or when you go to China, he will show it to you with the proof. Okay.
But on literature now, I'm based on my what I know and what I get the information on the online or even like a research on the Wikipedia or Google, the historical of koi. Yeah, koi gift from Dynasty Tang to the Japan.
Yep.
just to support the mountain area with the very food. Winter full of the snow, because the koi can live longer on the snow water, something like that. That's why koi sent to Japan, right?
Japan, yeah.
That's the information that I know. I still believe it until now. So before you, and maybe until you give me the literature of the book you already said, but based on my what I know.
就是他们就算你现在上网查还是什么，你还是查不到这个中国的锦鲤资料，就是反而是日本，就是说每一个人都认知说锦鲤，只懂说锦鲤是从日本发扬光大的。对，我们无论任何一个时候，不管是什么产物，谁是最强者，就会被世人所认同。
对，
目前在锦鲤界还是日本最强，所以这方面的信息会更多一些。但是随着现在苏姓的崛起，也有更多的超出日本的一些渔场的作品拿出来。
所以说要他们认知的话，就是要把这些文化再带出来，
对，
再教育这个全世界，再教育大众。
你要翻译给他听。
So in becauseAll this while, everybody buy fish from Japan, and when even in Google search, the updated is everything is from Japan, say for koi. China never do the homework to update all these things, and not many people know. Okay, the next step they will do is they will find all the evidence, and then they will introduce to the whole world very soon.Once this China koi industry is booming up, and in China now, actually they are planning to do some koi museum as well.
Oh, cool.
我是讲的，我们是中国已经开始要设立这个锦鲤博物馆、博物院，来讲述这个锦鲤的历史，要追随回这个锦鲤的时代，让大家全世界都知道、明白这个锦鲤的来源。
不仅仅是每个国家来确定，即使在我们所认可的大三家红白大正昭和，它也有同样的这样的说法，就是前些年大正和昭和一直是夺到冠军，是昭和和红白一直夺冠军，大正都没有出彩。所以
我们之前就说是先讲这个历史线，
对，
在他等他发问第二个问题，我们再讲述这个。大正的来源，
不是这个意思。我说的是说，即使同样是锦鲤，谁获奖最多，就会谁受到关注。这两年才是大正做出来一些比较有名的锦鲤，大家就会认可到大正。但是在前些年，大家只知道红白和昭和，所以锦鲤它是只看第一的。然后锦鲤的寓意在中国就是不断的淘汰，不断的胜出，最后变成成功的这个人。
这个我很难翻译。OK, the next question.
Okay. Let me give the one homework question. Okay. I know Kohaku is Japanese. I mentioned. Taisho Sansoku, we know that Taisho is a three cows become on Taisho era.
Yeah.
Right? This mean for me, this mean the, because of the koi name, give the name in Japanese. That's why we believe that koi is from Japan.Because all the
foreign
name is Japanese.
Like even Showa is produced during a year of Showa.
Showa era.
Yeah, Showa era. That's why.
Taisho Sansoku is a Taisho era. And this the mean. This the meaning. The Japanese Japanese
culture
and the Japanese emperor give the name, right?
Yes.
就是日本锦鲤的名字就是日本的那个帝王给的名字，就是哪一个时代嘛？红白是红白的时代，就
是
大正是大正的时代。
对。
然后昭和就是昭和年的时代，
对，
所生产出来，所以每一个人都已经认知说，这个就是代表，
对，
日本就是代表这个。
是的，在锦鲤的发展过程当中，日本是不可以忽略它的功劳的，然后。当然现在日本也是通过几代人两百年 不断不断的辛勤的付出，才培育出现在这种模样的好看的锦鲤。
I mean for this load ups, Japan is the one who produced this during this generation, and we will call it this a modern coin, like Showa, Sankei during the era. But if you're talking about the history, the earlier,
the oldest,
yeah,
the oldest.
Koi, color koi, already actually is there in China. Just that Japan produce more and make it more beautiful, and more people can accept it, and everybody have the idea is koi
from Japan.
Is from Japan.
Okay, I need your improvement. I need your argue about the. You said koi is from China, and I said koi from Japan. So because of what I know from the online and book, all book literature. Okay. So I think this is your homework. If you believe the koi is from China, just give me the more information about it. Why?
现在我们都是在争论嘛。你是说锦鲤是最初中国已经有了嘛？他是说锦鲤是日本的产物嘛？所以你一定要给他多一点资料，还有证明，让全世界都知道说，
没有问题。
锦鲤其实日本在说话有这些 ，actually before they have 说话 ，they only have 三 K， before they have 三 K， they only have 国画
布。
So before 国画布 ，China coin。So we need to show this information on this area,
right?
We missing history.
我们谈到一个物种呢，只是谈到它的起源，到它的发展，也就是现在和未来。我刚才讲的中国只是它的起源，因为日本它是一个岛屿，它没有淡水鱼的生存空间，是从大陆引进到日本，后来在日本发扬光大，但是未来还是希望要日本、中国、印度尼西亚国家一起都会做得更漂亮。
所以 ，Okay, all this started from China, then now go to Japan, and then you hope the next one after Taiwan, maybe the next one, then go to China again, and later on come to Indonesia also.
So we have one.
So we have a vision to create. That means it's go by generations.
That's the for the next generation. But we need because we like something with the history. History. I like koi because there is a history of koi. So if you can give me the information, I will happy to believe that.
So.
他喜欢锦鲤，就是因为他有一个历史。很多人都是喜欢一个历史性的产物，
对，
所以希望你可以给到他们这个历史性的证明。
我会把这个原件给到我们印尼的鱼友。
他 okay, he will prepare all these things, and then the next time he will show it to all Indonesian fans.
Wow,
then everybody will understand more.
I'm waiting for it.
He will, this is homework, okay?
From
China.
因为我也是从事这个专业的，就是我也很喜欢研究锦鲤的历史。
So he also like to study about history also.
Right.
So he will have all the link and information, the way to dig all this information out.
The missing history.
Yeah, cool. Missing history.
So nanti dipotong aja jadi untuk missing history.
Iya. Jadi ternyata after all these years, there's missing history about the original story of apa about the koi itself. Yeah, so Mr. Hendrik believes in from Japan, and both of you in believes in China. So it's interesting.